Hello everyone, myself Prithviraj Tambe, working as an assistant professor in Department of Electronics Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology Solapur. Let us today learn programmable array logic. So at the end of this video, students can examine the general structure of programmable array logic and they can also implement simple boolean functions using PAL. So what is PAL? PAL is a combinational programmable logic device, an integrated circuit with a programmable AND array and a fixed OR array. So PAL provides AND OR SOP implementation. Now let us learn the structure of PAL. So you have input lines which are connected to programmable AND array through buffer and inverter stage. So output of AND arrays, which are the product terms, are again connected to fixed OR arrays, and output of these OR arrays are again made available for the final usage through these last stage of buffer and inverters. So the point to be noted here is AND array is programmable whereas OR array is fixed. Inputs to the OR array are fixed, you cannot modify them. But whereas in AND array you can program the inputs which you can apply to the AND array. So let us recall. So with a programmable AND array with n number of input variables and their complements, multi-input AND gates can produce as maximum yes 2 raised to n number of AND terms. The point here you can note down, which is important, in PLDs the number of AND terms or the number of AND gates in the AND array stage is far less than the n variable mean terms, that is 2 raised to n. So the output of these programmable AND arrays are again applied or connected to fixed OR arrays, and you can use the outputs of these OR arrays as a realization of set of outputs in the form of SOP. So here you will see that inputs to the OR arrays are fixed, you cannot modify them. So how to use these PAL for the implementation of simple boolean functions? So here are some points you can note down. As discussed in the previous slides, the number of product terms, that is AND gates, are limited. Those are not always 2 to the n. So a set of boolean expressions need to be minimized so that the number of product terms never exceeds the limit set by these AND gates which are in the AND array of PAL. So the realization of a set of boolean function is totally based on product terms, not necessarily mean terms, and fuses are then programmed depending upon these product terms. So basically realization is purely SOP expressions. Now let us implement a simple boolean function through this example. So here we have three variable function f1, and the mean terms are provided here are 1, 4, 5 and 7. So here instead of using mean terms as it is, I will first minimize these mean terms, minimize this function using one of the minimization method, which is kmap. So after placing these min terms in the k-map, I have formed three groups, g1, g2, g3, and I can write the function f1 is equal to ac plus b bar c plus a b bar. So ac is the group 1 term, b bar c is group 2 term, and a b bar is group 3 term. Let us take again one more function f2, which is again a 3 variable function, which is summation of the mean terms 0, 1, 3, 5 and 7. Again, I am using here k-map for the minimization. So after putting the mean terms in the k-map, I found two groups, g1 and g2. For group 1, the expression is c. And for group 2, the AND term or product term is A bar B bar. So let us implement these two functions using PAL. So this is the implementation diagram where you can observe the connections. So first of all, observe here AND arrays are programmable. So you will see here cross at each section where you want connection. Whereas in the OR array, you will observe these connections are fixed. So dark dot is drawn at the section, meaning is you cannot modify these connections. These are fixed connections. Now to implement F1, which is AC plus B bar C plus A B bar, so you required three AND gates. So I will use these first three AND gates for F1. So for the first AND gate, inputs are A and C. So I will keep fuses of buffer A and buffer C, and I will blow all the other fuses corresponding to A bar, B bar and C bar. So after programming, I am having only here two connections for A and C. So this first AND gate output is nothing but AC. Next, second AND gate, the second AND term is here B bar C. So here I will keep the fuses of B bar and C as it is, where I will blow all the remaining fuses corresponding to the remaining input. So the output of this second AND gate is nothing but B bar C. Third AND term, A B bar. So for A B bar, I am connecting output of a buffer and output of inverter for inputs A B respectively. I will blow all the fuses corresponding to the remaining inputs. So these two fuses are intact. So the inputs to this third AND gate are A, B bar. So these three AND terms are ORed together to form function F1. Similarly, for function 2, which is C plus A bar B. So here first AND term is nothing but this C variable. So for the first AND gate for F2, I am going to keep C buffer output as it is, or fuse as it is, and I will blow all the remaining fuses corresponding to remaining input terminals. So the output of this fourth AND gate is C. The second AND term is A bar B bar. So for this term, I'm using fifth AND gate. So only two fuses will remain intact and all other fuses will be blown to achieve output of this fifth AND gate as A bar B bar. So you can observe here, for the last AND gate, sixth, all the fuses are blown because we are not using this gate. So for F2, we are going to only OR two AND gates outputs, which is C plus A bar B bar. So this is how you can implement simple Boolean functions using programmable array logic devices. To read further, you can refer these textbooks. Thank you.